We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
People who come to Cricut stay with Cricut, like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricut, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricut in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. smile. You're on Cricket.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
People who come to Cricut stay with Cricut. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricut, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricut in 2 words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode, activate. Smile, you're on Cricut.
Join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
And we welcome you to Gulfport, the Gulfport Sportsplex here in Gulfport, Mississippi. Day 2, game 2 of the SWAC softball tournament. Our second elimination game. One team has already been eliminated, and that was the Lady Tigers of Jackson State, as they lost 3-1. To Texas Southern. Texas Southern moves on. They'll play tomorrow morning at 9. In this second game of day 2, the Lady Braves of Alcorn State University, they lost a tough one last night. 1-0 to Alabama State. BAMU lost yesterday to Grambling 3-1. So this will be the second elimination game, and sort of an interesting one is Lady Braves head coach Eugenia Fernandez was a longtime assistant at FAMU. As we get ready for this second game, FAMU is the home team, so the Lady Braves will bat first, and Christian Edwards will lead it off for the Lady Braves here in this second game. Nadia Zenteno on the mound for FAMU. Here is the first pitch, and Edwards aggressive, going up hacking, and she fouls it off. We're right at the top of the hour. First pitch, 1-1 the count. A couple of games coming up after this, Bethune-Cookman and Prairie View, Grambling and Bama State later. 0-1 the count. The pitch from Zenteno, inside, 1-1. Well, a low scoring game, 3-1. The highest scoring game we've had has been 6 runs, and that was Bethune-Cookman winning over Texas Southern 6-0. And there's a base hit right center field off the bat of Christian Edwards. A single to right center, and the Lady Braves are off to a good start. Edwards hitting 333 in the tournament, or fourth at bat. And Kennedy Terry at the plate for the Lady Braves, or fourth at bat, no average. Nadia Zenteno, 8 wins, 8-9 during the season. There's a bunt attempt, runner going, and the throw, it hits her. It hits Edwards, a stolen base. So the Lady Braves aggressive here at the start, a single by Edwards and a stolen base. Good jump, good start for the Lady Braves. So Edwards at second, nobody out. Terry, the left fielder, makes the pitch outside. The crew for this second game, Mike Hall behind the plate, Thad Bridges, the first base umpire, and Kathy Graff at third. 2-0 the count. Which is outside, 3-0. It was a throwing error that gave Alabama State the win in the seventh inning. 3-0 the count. This is slapped in the shallow left, and a running catch in left for the first out. Left fielder blasting game hauls it in. One away.
In 11, Janice Wells.
I'll bring up Janice Wells, her second at bat. Tucker towel in. A lot of softball players have towels in their back pockets. Got to be tucked in. Can't be hanging out. Janice Wells stands in for the Lady Braves of Alcorn. The fourth seed in the East. First year head coach Eugenia Fernandez pitches outside, and a throw, and she is out at third as Christian Edwards tried to steal third. Will Coach Fernandez challenge? No, apparently not. Two out, bases empty. Like, take a look at that one. If possible. Zenteno brings it home. Strike call. We've had a bunch of challenges so far in this tournament. We do have replay. Count is 1-1, 2 out. Bases empty, scoreless. Zenteno, 107 innings pitched this season for the Lady Rattlers. Riser is high. 53 strikeouts, 52 walks, and 107 and two-thirds innings. The count is 2-1. Off speed is high, 3-1. Wind has picked up here. No rain as of yet. We had a couple of mini rain delays yesterday. The forecast is pretty favorable today. I think we'll be okay today. Forecast a little bit more favorable for rain tomorrow. Here's a shot in the center field and a diving catch in center field for the final out by Denia Davis charging in. A couple of nice plays in the outfield and left and in center. A single, runner caught stealing, and nobody left. We'll take a timeout here after a half inning. Scoreless here on the SWAC Digital Network.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Here in Gulfport, Mississippi, where the wind has picked up, clouds overhead. Artificial surface, so rain's not a problem. Lightning is, and we haven't had that so far. Let's hope that doesn't take place. We've had two delays yesterday. Could have been 30 minutes, but I think because of the fact that this field is turfed all the way around, there's no dirt home plate or dirt pitching mound. You don't have to cover it. So once the rain goes away, you get warmed up, you get right back at it. So far, so good here. Lady Rattlers coming to the plate. 13-11 in the Eastern Division. 20-23 overall. And they're facing the Lady Braves' best pitcher in Alexa Villamoy. Eugenia Fernandez, the head coach of Alcorn, decided to go with her number one in game two. Talked with her about that yesterday, and she says she's aware of the fact that teams expect to see the number one, so she wants to throw a little wrinkle in it. We've seen this, you know, we've seen it throughout the tournament, going with the number two yesterday and then coming back to the number one. There's a one hopper to Villamoy, and a bang bang play as the Speedy Davis is thrown out. Davis with 14 stolen bases on the season. And when she was hustling down the line, the chopper right to Villamoy. Oh, that was close at first. Even as slow of a chopper as that was, still bang, bang play at first. One out, it'll bring up Kayla Irvis, the senior. This is a veteran lineup. First pitch misses. The first six in the starting lineup for FAMU are all seniors. Davis, Irvis, Hill, Obley, Morgan, and Fox, they're all seniors. Here's the 1-0. This is 2-0, charging in, expecting a bunt. 2-0 the count to the number two hitter, Irvis, in the bottom of the first inning. FAMU, the home team for the second game. 2-0 the count. This is from Villamoy, 3-0. Villamoy, when she's on, she's pretty good. And for the most part this season, she has been really, really solid. It's pitch ball four and a one-out walk to Irvis. And it'll bring up the senior, Rianne Hill, at 321 during the season. Rianne Hill with seven runs batted in. Runner at first. First base runner for the Lady Rattlers. Pitched her all straight back. Look at Irvis, 19 stolen bases at first. You got four players in this starting nine with at least 14 stolen bases during the regular season. So they're gonna put pressure on you defensively. Here's a bunt, foul straight back. Of course, Alcorn head coach Eugenia Fernandez worked and was a part of three MEAC championship squads under longtime coach Wiggins at FAMU. Count is 1-2. One and two the count, scoreless, bottom one. There's a ground ball back to Villamoy. Could be 2-1-6, and a fielder's choice there. So a 1-6 fielder's choice. He had a pretty good runner
and headed to the plate.
And he'll right back to Viamoy.
Is number eight.
Over the short.
Janae Mobley.
Just too much speed. So a fielder's choice, and Janae Mobley at the plate for the Lady Rattlers. She had 345 during the season with a couple of home runs and 23 runs batted in. Two out, runner at first. There's a shot too short. Line shots a short. Lockridge hauls it in. A walk and one stranded. We'll take this break. Top two coming up after this from Gulfport.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
We welcome you back to Gulfport. Home Depot, one of the sponsors of the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Home Depot always has the Retool Your School program in which universities and bands of supporters of various HBCUs can vote and win a $50,000 grant courtesy of Home Depot. It's always a good competition. And those schools are putting that 50 grand to use for various projects around the various campuses. Lady Braves coming up here in the top of the second inning. Marche Hunt at the plate for the Lady Braves. Fourth at bat in the tournament for Marche Hunt. Facing Zenteno. Hunt going up swinging and fouls it off to the right side. 1-1 the count. The Rattlers won their final game of the regular season 7-4 over Alabama A&M. Trying to get some makeup games in. The weather did play has played a factor in a lot of the softball as well as baseball games. This Lady Braves team had to play a makeup the Wednesday before the start of the tournament at home against Grambling. Here's a shot up the middle. Base hit left center field. Hunt, second hit for the Lady Braves. Second base hit, second base runner off of Zenteno.
For Alcorn State.
Leadoff is on for the second inning in a row.
At the plate is number one, Kelsey Lockwood.
We talk about the leadoff. The leadoff, the first person to bat in the inning. Typically, when the leadoff gets on, you score. Lady Braves second inning in a row, they've had the leadoff on. A bunt here, attempt by Lockridge. This pitch is high. Obviously, early in the game, you want to sacrifice. You want to move runners along, put yourself in position. 1-0 the count. Top two, game two, day two. Scoreless. Which is low. Marche Hunt not known to steal bases. On first with the leadoff hit. This is popped up, foul and out of play. During the season, FAMU a four-game winning streak. They won three in a row. They've had their moments. This pitch misses. The Lady Braves had to earn their way here to the tournament. A sweep over Southern University, late season at home. in the final game against the Jaguars, they were up 5-0. Strike called. Southern came back and tied it up. And in the bottom of the seventh inning, Marche Hunt hit a walk-off two-run home run to complete the sweep. And that game was the difference. Get the Lady Braves in the tournament. Here's a shot to center, and it's going to be a running catch in center. Well, we've seen some nice plays in center field as Davis hauls that in. She's made a couple of nice plays here. That ball was hit hard. You can see hit right on the nose and left center. Davis, the running catch. So one on, one out. Akiria Howard, freshman, at the plate for the Lady Braves. One out, one on in this scoreless game, top of the second inning. There's a ground ball to short, off of short. Everybody's safe. It's an E6. There on the shortstop, Mobley. Routine ground ball, Mobley ranged to her left. It came up a little bit on her. That's one that you typically can make. So E6, two on. Hunt at second, Howard at first. Felton, the catcher for the Lady Braves. Her freshman. It's in her first at bat in this tournament in a big spot. Felton, a little flare, base hit, shallow right field. And everybody is safe and they're loaded up. So two singles and an error, and they're loaded up for the Lady Braves.
Braves now with two out, a runner on the wing, the first and third.
Oh, well, they say a fielder's choice. Plate. So the runner's out at second. So Felton at first, Howard taken out at second, so Hunt at third. So first and third, two out, and this is popped up to left. And the side is retired. So the Lady Braves strand two, a single, an error, fielder's choice,
one hit, two left.
First two stranded for the Lady Braves. We go to the bottom of the second inning, scoreless. We'll be right back from Gulfport.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
Here in Gulfport, the Mississippi Gulf Coast, Biloxi. Not too far, Mobile, not too far. Tallahassee, not too far. We find ourselves here 30 in a row down in the Gulf Coast region. We've talked about the various places where the tournament has been. Irondale, Alabama, right outside of Birmingham, as well as on the campus of Alabama State. Bottom of the second inning, Nia Morgan, the catcher, leading it off. For FAMU, Morgan hit 263 during the season. Morgan fouled it straight back. 1-1 the count, bottom two again. Another low scoring start. Another low scoring affair, it appears. You got the number one starter for game two for the Lady Braves. Alexa Villamoy is an Alabama State transfer. There was some talk about her maybe pitching against her former team. Talked with Bama State's coach about that last night, and he was very familiar, obviously, with what Villamoy could do. Talked with Bama State's coach last night about that 1-0 game. He warned me that that game was going to be tricky. You just never know how these games go. 1-0 on a throwing error. Here's a shot in a deep left center field, and this ball's going to go all the way to the wall off the bat of Morgan. She's got a stand-up double to lead it off for FAMU.
Morgan with a double in left field.
Had her played medium depth.
Runner on second for Florida A&M.
Kennedy Terry watched it go over her head, and a stand-up double for Morgan. Morgan had 13 doubles during the season. And it'll bring up the designated player, Natasha Fox. Hit 190 during the season. You assume and expect a sacrifice here. Oh, she's swinging. Turning her loose here. 0-1 to count. Bottom of the second inning. Leadoff double. Think sacrifice. She's swinging on this first pitch. Let's see what the second pitch brings. Up, she's squaring. And she bunts it straight back. 0-2. So now she has to protect the plate. Lead off double by Morgan in the bottom of the second inning. Two more games here in Gulfport coming up. Coming up at 3 o'clock, it'll be Prairie View and Bethune-Cookman. And in the nightcap, Bama State and Grambling. Well, these matchups, you don't see them during the regular season. That's why they're refreshing to see them in the tournament. Here's the 0-2. Here's a dribbler back to Villamoy, bumbles it. And her throw is low, stays with it, just gets her. Bang, bang play. And Morgan to third. Let's take a look at it. Villamoy bobbled it. Breaks down, stays with it. And makes a decent throw. One out, Morgan to third. It'll bring up Amaya Gaynor, the third baseman. Wind whisking, blowing in. This pitch strike called. Gaynor hit 238 during the season. There's a runner at third in front of her. Chance for the Rattlers to grab the lead. Runner at third, one out. They're in at first and third, back at second and short. The pitch, low. 1-1. Bottom two here in Gulfport. Texas Southern has moved on, eliminating Jackson State. The winner of this game will move on. The loser's eliminated. 1-1 to count with one out. Chopper right side, backhanded at second. The run scores, here's the throw home, and it is too late. So a 4-3. It was hit in the hole, good play, saving a base hit. But just too much in the hole. And all Cotton can do is get the out in front of her. And the Speedy Morgan scores, and the Lady Rattlers lead 1-0. So base is empty, pitch is low to Mia Blasingame. She had 303 during the regular year. 1-0, FAMU with the lead here in the second inning. Villamoy brings it home. The chopper, fair down the third baseline. Blasingame with a single, a base hit, high chopper. Janice Wells just couldn't get there.
Hit it to the plate is number six.
Two out single.
That'll
bring up Kiana Watson. She had 270 during the year. As a runner at first with two out. 1-0 Lady Rattlers with the lead over the Lady Braves. Here in the second elimination game of day two. Pitch strike called. 0-1 the count. Two out. Here's the 0-1. Popped up. And it's going to be caught at third. And the side is retired. As Janice Wells calls it in. A run on two hits. No errors and one stranded. FAMU's left two. Lady Braves have left two. We'll be back with the third inning. Lady Braves down 1-0. We'll be right back after this. Timeout.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Here in Gulfport, Mississippi, where it's 83 degrees, high humidity, it feels like 90 with a sunny sky. And on the turf, it feels warmer than that. You can kind of feel the heat radiating where we are. We've got a tent over us, but you can feel that humidity and the heat from the turf. Which is high ball one. We're underway here in this third inning. Desmond Cotton leading it off for the Lady Braves, 9-1-2 for Alcorn. Cotton, Edwards, and Terry in the third. Dribbler to third, cutting it off in a strong throw, one out. Good play at third. Gaynor cut it off. If it was fielded at short, she probably would have beat it out.
One out.
Take a look
at
that.
Top of the batting
range to her left, cut it off. And then if the shortstop gets it, she's got to throw it across her body, and who knows where that might lead to. One out. Top of the lineup. Edwards, it's a pitch inside, ball one. It is Zenteno on the mound for the Lady Rattlers, the home team. Pitch high. I was talking about it yesterday. I got a chance to visit Tallahassee for the first time during basketball season. Really enjoyed. Of course, it's the capital of the state of Florida. Enjoy the campus, the arena, the stadium. Got a new press box. High expectations there for FAMU football. 2-1 the count. One out. I was going to guess will Willie Simmons make an appearance here? This pitch is high. Probably not. 3-1 the count. One out. 1-0. Lady Rattlers. Here's a 3-1. There's a shot down the right side, and that's going to drop for a base hit. Cut off. It's going to be a double for Edwards. So she's got a single and a double for the Lady Braves. Took it the other way.
Edwards with a double right.
Good piece of hitting.
That
ball's not cut off and right by Irvis. That's probably a triple. So runner at second. Edwards in the leadoff spot, 2-for-2. And now Kennedy Terry stands in. There's a bunt. Foul. For those in Tallahassee that may know or may not know much about Willie Simmons, one of Willie Simmons' favorite snacks, and I joke with him, and I'll do that at media day. I think I might bring him a pack. He loves flaming hot sunflower seeds, his favorite snack. Here's a one of his favorite snacks. Ground ball back to Zenteno, and she throws out Terry.
12 for the Braves, the runner on third. Headed to the plate.
So a runner at third for the Lady Braves.
11, Denise Wells.
Denise Wells stands in. She flies to center. So for those in Tallahassee, if you want to put a smile on Willie Simmons' face, bring him a bag of Flamin' Hot Sunflower Seeds. He definitely would appreciate it. Two-out runner at third. Here's the pitch. Low ball one. I didn't get a chance to bring him a bag when I saw him. But there was, I think, at Media Day a couple of years ago, I did bring him a bag or two. 1-0 the count with two out. Lady Braves with a chance to tie the game up here in the third inning. This pitch is low. 2-0 the count. Of course, the commissioner yesterday talked about SWAC Football Media Day coming up mid-July or so. A lot of storylines, including where will FAMU land in the pecking order, according to the voters. Here's the 1-1. Low, 2-1. I would suspect FAMU might be picked to win the East. I don't know. We'll see. Time called as Denise Wells had a towel out of her back pocket. And Coach Fernandez didn't know what that was about. 3-0 the count. 3-0. 3-0 the count, two out. Runner at third. She's also asking about the count. Here's the 3-0, ball four.
Ball four, running in first, Alcorn State.
The Lady Braves have four hits.
On the first and third.
They're now first and third with two out.
25,
Marche Hunt. Hunt singled to left center her last time up. Edwards with two hits, Hunt with a single, and Felton with a single. Time called here. MU with a your head coach, and you know, she is obviously very passionate, intense, just trying to make everyone aware of the situation. Here in the top of the third inning, where the Lady Braves have an opportunity. Kamis Patterson, the head coach for FAMU. Assistant coach Kyra Brown. Lady Braves have a former all-conference pitcher as their number one assistant, Ambria Dorsey. Was all-conference and pitcher of the year in the conference a few years back when she was pitching. So the Lady Braves have runners on at first and third. We'll see how this is played here with Marche Hunt. Number four hitter, the cleanup for the Lady Braves, a chance to tie the game. Or maybe with an extra base hit to give her team the lead. Hunt facing Zenteno. First and third, two out. Top three. Lady Braves stranded two in the second. They have two on here in the third. Hunt pops it up. Foul territory. Is there a play? No. Just lands deep on top of the dugout. Down the third base side. Running out of room was Gaynor. 0-1 the count. Shea Hunt trying to tie this game. New softball. 0-1 the count. Two out, first and third. 1-0 FAMU. Here's the 0-1. Hunt, ground ball, foul. Down the third baseline. 0-2 the count. A good turnout here, day two. The attendance was terrific yesterday, all day. Good crowds here so far. A couple of games coming up. Zenteno gets the sign. Hunt in the hole. Stays alive. Oh, and two the count. Two out, two on. 1-0 Lady Rattlers. Chance for the Lady Braves. And they tie it up. A base hit off the bat of Marche Hunt. She's 2-for-2, and the Lady Braves have tied it up at 1. RBI single for Hunt. Scores Edwards. 1-1 game.
At the plate is number 1, Kelsey Lockridge.
So Kelsey Lockridge at the plate. Going to get a pinch runner.
9-for-25.
So a pinch runner for the Lady Braves. Kamaya Dillon will pinch run for Hunt. Well, Lockridge at the plate, trying to keep the inning going and give the Lady Braves the lead. Pitch misses outside, ball one. Good piece of hitting by Marche Hunt. Fouled off some tough pitches. Kept herself alive. And she's singled to try this game. 1-1 game in the third. Riser is high. Count is 2-0.
In number 9, Kamaya Dillon.
2-0 the count, two out, two on, 1-1 game. Here's a shot in the left center. It's going to drop for a base hit. Lady Braves lead 2-1. Make it 3-1, and a stand-up double for Lockridge. Clears the bases. 3-1, Lady Braves.
With a slam in left field. 2 runs scored and 1 run second.
Bases clearing double for Lockridge all the way to the wall. Scoring Wells and Hunt, and the Lady Braves have played it 3 here in this third inning. 3-1. Lady Braves. 3 runs, 3 hits, and a walk for Alcorn. They have a 3-1 lead. Zakaria Howard at the plate reached on via an error her last time up, so the Lady Braves respond. After FAMU jumped out 1-0, Lady Braves with a 3 spot here in the third inning. 3-1. So 3-1 Alcorn here in this elimination game. Here in the top of the third. This is high. So leadoff. Set it up, the leadoff. Edwards with a double. Then Terry moved the runner over, then a walk, then a single by Hunt. Tied it up, and a bases clearing double as a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Lockridge around third, and she will score. Howard comes through in the clutch. RBI single, scoring Lockridge, and it's 4-1, Lady Braves. Fourth hit in this inning, 4 runs for the Lady Braves. 4-1 Alcorn.
Into the plate is number 21, Alana Felton.
Felton singled the last time up. And we're going to get a pinch runner or a pinch hitter here. Coach Camise Patterson coming out. We might have a pitching change coming up here. Yep, we will have a pinch runner. Sarah Kennedy will pinch run for Howard. As you see, a base hit up the middle drives home a run. And it looks like we might have a new pitcher in the game here for FAMU. And a pitching change coming up. We'll tell you about it when we come back. Lady Braves with 4 in this inning on 4 hits, and they lead 4-1. We'll be back after this timeout.
you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Welcome you back to Gulfport, where Lauren Peppers, who pitched yesterday in relief here today. So Peppers, the second pitcher for Zenteno, and Zenteno 2 2/3 innings. Four runs on 7 hits. So 4 runs on 7 hits for Zenteno. She's walked 1 and didn't strike out anyone. And the runner at second belongs to her, as Lauren Peppers into the game, trying to get this third out for FAMU. But the Lady Braves, 4 runs, 4 hits in this third inning. A double by Edwards set it up, 1 out. A walk to Wells, single by Hunt to tie it up. Double by Lockridge, plated 2, and a single by Howard scored Lockridge. So 4 straight of reach base. Two out.
New lady in the circle for Florida A&M is number 11, Lauren Pepper.
Lana Felton singled her last time up. 4-1 Alcorn here in the third. Wind starting to pick up. And the pitch is a strike called. Lady Braves 4, Lady Rattlers 1, top of the third inning. The 0-1. Foul just to the right of FAMU's dugout. Down the third base side, and the count is 0-2. 0-2 the count, 2 out. 4-1 Alcorn, top 3. Game started right at top of the hour, high noon. Here's the 0-2. Gets this one foul. The key at bat in this inning, I think, was Marche Hunt battling some tough pitches, an RBI single to tie it, and Lockridge double, and then Howard single added to the lead. 4-1 Lady Braves here in the top of the third inning. Lady Braves, Lady Rattlers, third inning. Pitch from Peppers. Another foul. I think that's been key. The Lady Braves really battling these pitchers here. Four to one. Horn with the lead. Trying to eliminate the Lady Rattlers. The loser of this game's eliminated. The winner will play at noon tomorrow. Here's the 0-2. A little flare down the left side. It's going to drop foul. Cal remains 0-2. 4-1 ASU. four in this third inning. Here's the 0-2. Another foul. Eddie Brace battling at the plate. Cal remains 0-2, two out. Four to one. Here's the 0-2. Roll the first, 1-2. One and two, the count. The pitch popped up, another foul. Alana felt it really battling here. One and two the count. The pitch. A riser, 2-2. Braves really waiting on their pitches, making these Lady Rattler pitchers work. And that's an aspect of it we don't talk about. You talk about quality at bats. 2-2 with two out. Full count. Three and two, the count.
3-2, full count.
Freshman Alana Felton. Four straight freshmen at the bottom of the lineup for Alcorn. Howard, Felton, Hall, and Cotton. Full count, 3-2, two out. All four. So first and second.
Headed to the plate is number seven,
Micah Hall. Rounded to second her last time up. Two out, two on. Which is high, ball one. Peppers taking the place of Zentino. 2 2/3 innings. Four runs, seven hits, walked one, didn't strike out anyone. Lauren Peppers in for her. Here's the 1-0. Swing and a miss. Pitch at her eyes. 1-1 the count. One and one the count, two out. Two on here in the third inning, a long third inning. Lady Braves have played it four. 4-1 Alcorn, here's the 1-1 pitch. Low 2-1. Two and one the count. Here's the 2-1, ground ball foul outside of third. Count is even, 2-2 with two out. A long third inning, the Lady Braves really getting quality at bats, taking advantage of the opportunities. 2-2 the count, two out. 4-1, Lady Braves trying to extend this inning. Here's the 2-2 from Peppers. Another foul. Count remains 2-2. Peppers in for Zentino. The pitch. High fly ball in the left. And the side is retired. Good inning for the Lady Braves as they scored four, sending eight to the plate. Four runs and four hits to left. Lady Braves have left four. Lady Braves with a 4-1 lead. And the Lady Rattlers coming up in the bottom of the third inning, top of the lineup. Coming up after this, timeout. We'll be right back.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Resume run. Hydration drop. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
We welcome you back to Gulfport. Glad you can join us here on the SWAC Digital Network as well here on this day two. Glad you can join us here. 4-1, Lady Braves with the lead. Trying to eliminate the Lady Rattlers. Alexa Viamoy, the number one starter, pitching in this second game. And the first pitch misses, ball one, the leadoff hitter, Anaya Davis. Davis hits it down the right side, foul. Count is 1-1. One and one the count. One and one the count here in the bottom of the third inning. FAMU, the home team. Here's the 1-1, a shot off of Viamoy, fielded at third, and the throw is close, safe at first. Base hit, carried off of Viamoy to third. Janice Wells got it out quickly. So the leadoff is on for FAMU. And here comes Eugenia Fernandez. She might want to challenge this. I think she's. And there's going to be a challenge. So there will be a challenge here. And so Eugenia Fernandez will challenge this call. The ruling on the field is that she was safe at first. Kind of hard to tell here with that angle. It's a good angle. It's just a matter of freeze framing it. Good look at it. Of course, in the control center behind us, they're reviewing it. They've got umpires in that control center to look at what you're seeing is what they're seeing. Now, in the past, they would have a monitor where they could take a look at it right there on the field. But they're just communication. And they call her safe. It didn't hurt to challenge that. That was bang, bang play. Your season's on the line. You know, the previous game, Kevin Montgomery, the head softball coach at Jackson State, went with a challenge just trying to get a base runner on. I mean, like he said, you can hear him on the field. You can't take the timeout with you. You got to go with it. You may not win it, but you got to push for it anyway. So leadoff single by Davis. Kayla Irvis at the plate. The pitch is high, ball one. 4-1 here in the elimination game, the second elimination game. Two other games, the winners' games, Bethune-Cookman, Prairie View, Grambling, Bama State. 1-0 the count. 4-1 Lady Braves. Here's a bunt. Right side. And this is going to be a bunt single. They have the runner hung up briefly, but getting back in is Davis to second. So a bunt single by Irvis. Runners on at first and second. So back-to-back singles for FAMU, and the Lady Rattlers have something going.
Hit it to the plate. Hit number 12,
Brianne Hill, the shortstop, hitting with fielder's choice her last time up, and Eugenia Fernandez coming out. We'll take a timeout here. We'll be right back after this. 4-1 Lady Braves with the lead, first and second. Nobody out. We'll be right back.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Two on for the Lady Rattlers coming out of the timeout. So runners on at first and second. We'll see what Coach Patterson does here. Does she put on the sack and make it second and third, or does she turn heel loose? She's squaring, giving herself up, lays it down. Fair ball. Here's the throw. Thrown away. Runner's going to score. Runner to third. Everybody's safe. Runner to second, and she is safe. Everybody's safe. FAMU with a run. It's on the butt, ball thrown away. Runner scored, everybody safe. It's 4-2, nobody out, second and third. And Mobley at the plate. Four to two, Lady Rattlers. And they have a chance to tie it up with a base hit. Second and third, nobody out. Mobley, a wild pitch. And it was on a line. Not a deep backstop here. So on a line, wild pitch over the head of the catcher. It's going to come back to her quickly. And of course, it's turf. So it's going to hit the turf and just kind of carry him back to the catcher fairly quickly. 1-0 the count. Mobley giving herself up, now going to swing away. I think that's just a show. I think she's swinging away, unless they're talking about a squeeze home of a run. Count is 2-0. 4-2. Lady Braves over FAMU in elimination game. Here's the pitch popped up. Two singles, including a bunt single, and E2 has scored a run, moving up the runners. Second and third, nobody out. 2-1 the count, 4-2 Lady Braves. The 2-1 from Viamoy. Low ball three. It looks like we may be headed to the highest scoring game of the tournament so far. Wonder how long these low scoring games will last. It looks like, I mean, could go either way right now. Here's the 3-1. Popped up. Shallow right center. And this ball's going to be caught. One out. Shallow right center. Lady Braves second baseman Cotton was called off by Michael Hall and Wright. Second and third. One out. 4-2. Naya Morgan doubled her last time up. Second and third, one out. 4-2, Lady Braves. This pitch rolled to the catcher. Between her legs, can't do anything with it. Runners can't move up. Well, the highest scoring game so far has been 6 runs. We've got 6 runs here. We approach the halfway point of this game. One and 0 the count. Pitch from Villamoy. Foul off to the left side. Halfway through day two of the 2023 SWAC softball tournament. 4-2, Alcorn trying to eliminate FAMU. This is popped up. Hunt at first hauls it in. Well, a run in. It was second and third, nobody out. Now second and third, two out. And it'll bring up Natasha Fox, the DP.
Here's number 19, Natasha Fox.
So Fox stands in. With runners on at second and third. So Villamoy wants a new softball. Softballs get scuffed up, affecting the grip. And the pitchers just want something they can really get a handle on. Two out, two on for the Rattlers. Lady Braves clinging to a 4-2 lead. Pitch is low, ball one to Fox. Four hits for FAMU, 2 runs for FAMU. And they've left 2 on. Lady Braves have left 4 on. Here's a 1-0. A little dribbler to third. And the throw across is bobbled at first. A run is in. 2 runs are in. And we have a tie game. E5. A little dribbler to third. And Janice Wells' throw could not be handled. They're calling it a base hit. That scores 2, and we're tied up.
At the plate.
So we have a 4-4 game. 3 runs on 3 hits for FAMU. Well, it was 1-0 FAMU, then 4-1 Lady Braves, now 4-4. And we have our highest scoring game officially of the SWAC tournament. Previous high of 6, now it's 8. 4 runs apiece, 4-4. Bottom third inning. Gator at the plate, the number 7 hitter. Pitch strike called. 7 to the plate, 3 runs, 3 hits in error. We have a 4-4 game. 0-1 the count. Here's the 0-1. Ground ball foul down the left side. 0-2. When you see these mistakes made, if you're a pitcher, you just gotta pitch through it all. 4-4 game in the third inning here in Gulfport. Lady Braves were down 1-0, up 4-1. Now it's 4-4 in the third. The pitch, ground ball to third. The throw across is high, and the side is retired. High throw from Wells, and that takes care of FAMU. They send 7 to the plate, 3 runs, 3 hits, an error, and 1 left. FAMU has left 3, Lady Braves have left 4. Speaking of 4, fourth inning coming up after this timeout.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
People who come to Cricut stay with Cricut. Like one of our favorite customers, Michelle.
I started my own app company, and with Cricut, I'm able to answer calls from my engineers and investors and know my signal's going to be great. If I had to describe Cricut in two words, they would be reliable and affordable.
5G boss mode activate. Smile, you're on Cricut.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
3-2s, how long was that going to last us? 4-4 game here, midway through. 9-1-2 for the Lady Braves here in the top of the fourth inning. Cotton, Edwards, and Terry. Cotton grounded to third her last time up. Lauren Peppers in relief of Zenteno. She's off the hook. It's pitch strike call. And I say that means that Zenteno is no longer pitcher of record, as the Lady Rattlers battle back. Zenteno went 2 2/3 innings, 4 runs, 7 hits, but she's off the hook and Pepper's game at the moment. Pitch to Cotton, ground ball to third, backhanded, scoop throws, one out. A backhand by Gaynor. One out here in the fourth. Top of the lineup, Christian Edwards, single, double. Stole the base. Third at bat. Got a brand new game. 4-4 game. Base is empty, one out. Pitch strike called. Oh, I won the count. Mike Hall, the home plate umpire. Thad Bridges at first. Kathy Graft at third. Here's the 0-1. Popped up on the infield. Caught at third. Quickly two away. As Gaynor hauls it in. Two away.
At the plate is number 11, Denise Whale.
Here's the pitch, strike called. Oh, one the count. The 0-1. Terry grounded right back to the pitcher. Peppers, close, safe at first. Infield single, good hustle by Terry. And to bring up Janice Wells.
Lady Braves down with a runner on first.
Runner at first, two out. Infield single. Janice Wells fly to center and walked. Two out, runner at first. Peppers, who had a long stint yesterday, brings it home. Off speed, strike called. The winner of this game plays tomorrow at noon. The loser of this game is eliminated. Lady Braves lost a tough one last night, 1-0 in the seventh inning to Bama State. Bama State will play Grambling later. The pitch high, 1-1. A couple of good games on the back end of day two. Bethune Cookman, they won 6-0 over Texas Southern. They take on Prairie View, who beat Jackson State 2-1. 1-1 the count. And then later, Grambling, who beat FAMU 3-1. Taking on Bama State, that beat this Lady Braves team 1-0. 1-1 the count. Pitch from Peppers. Roll to home plate. Count is 2-1. Two and one, two out. Here's the 2-1. Ground ball right back to Peppers on a hop, and the side is retired. A single and one left. The Lady Braves have stranded five. Bottom four coming up after this timeout from Gulfport.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Hydration dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
Welcome you back to Gulfport. We are in the bottom of the fourth inning. 4-4 game here, bottom four.
Heading into the bottom of the fourth, Mia Blasingame.
Blasingame at the plate. First pitch low, ball one. We are underway here in the bottom of the fourth inning. It was 1-0 FAMU, then 4-1 Lady Braves. Now 4-4 in the fourth. Blasingame, a foul tip. Catcher couldn't hold it. Four-four game. Glad you can join us here from warm and sultry Gulfport, Mississippi, day two. Real feel in the 90s, even though it's got a wind. Count is 1-2. 1-2 the count. One, two pitch. Swing and a miss on an inside pitch. Blasting game. One out. And for Viamoy, that is her first strikeout. Yana Watson lined to third her last time up in the second inning. Second at bat, she's up in the fourth. Good strike call on the inside corner from Viamoy. It's a 4-4 game. I mean, you expect teams to battle, teams to compete. And we'll one the count, one out. The 0-1, a little chopper foul off to the left side. Count is 0-2. One out. 0-2. We approach the halfway point of day two. Second elimination game of the day. Jackson State was eliminated by Texas Southern. There's a chopper up the middle. Second baseman fields, and it's an infield single. Again, that was hit deep in the hole.
Watson with a single at first.
And the Lady Braves Cotton did what she could. Infield single.
Janiyah Davis.
And Janiyah Davis at the plate. Six hits for the Lady Rattlers. Lady Braves with eight hits. Here's a fly ball in the center. Edwards is there. Shallow center and hauls it in.
Rattlers now with two out, runner on first.
Two out, runner at first. Now to bring up Michaela Irvis. Walked and a bunt single.
Irvis at the plate.
Irvis 1-for-1 with a walk. Pitch strike called. So six hits for FAMU. Lady Braves have out-hit the Lady Rattlers 8-6, but it's a 4-4 game in the fourth. The pitch from Viamoy, low, runner going. The throw across is too late. A stolen base by Watson. Watson stole 20 bases during the season, so that's typical for her. And the count is 1-1. Lady Rattlers are base hit away from perhaps grabbing the lead again. 4-4 game, Rattlers have left runners in the first three innings. They've left three. Here's the pitch, a ground ball, base hit in the right field. Watson around third to throw home, and it's too late. RBI single by Irvis, scoring Watson, and FAMU back out on top.
One run scored, a runner on second.
Irvis on base for the third time. FAMU back up by one, 5-4. We'll bring up Rhianne Hill.
Rhianne
Hill, back and forth we go. 5-4, Lady Rattlers in the bottom of the fourth inning. Well, the Rattlers will run on two hits. It was an infield single by Watson. She stole second. Irvis brought her home. So after the Lady Braves were up 4-1, now they're down 5-4. And Sophia Moy had to pitch through it. Starting pitcher for FAMU is done. Zenteno was let off the hook. And this is Pepper's game. Here's a fly ball in the right center field, and this ball's gonna be caught by Edwards. A running catch in right center field. Side is retired, a run, two hits, a stolen base, one left. We'll take a break here. Fifth inning coming up, 5-4. FAMU, top five, coming up after this timeout.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Field in for the moment. We'll see if she comes out for the sixth inning. Lady Braves, top of the fifth. Well, we'll see if Villamoy comes out the bottom of the fifth inning. Marche Hunt at the plate. She's 2-for-2 with an RBI. Five, four, Lady Rattlers. Pitch is high, ball one. 1-0 the count. Third inning of work for Peppers. Now, she started yesterday. Let's see how much she's got left. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss. Count is 1-1. 1-1 the count, top of the fifth inning. Lady Rattlers, the home team for this second game of day two. 5-4, FAMU. Here's the 1-1. Popped up, foul and out of play. Count is 1-2. Hunt digs in. Peppers brings it home. Off speed, way out in front was Hunt.
Like a hit off an engine between a freight train and a golf cart. That ought to be good.
One out. Hunt way out in front on that pitch. One out. It'll bring up
one out for the Braves.
Kelsey Lockridge.
Is number one, Kelsey Lockridge.
Lockridge at the plate. One out in the fifth. Lockridge, RBI double, fly to center. 5-4, FAMU, top of the fifth inning. Loser of this game is eliminated. The winner will be back here tomorrow at noon. Is the 1-0. Riser is high. 2-0 the count. Pitch from Peppers. Foul off to the left side. Count is 2-1. Two and one, one out, bases empty. 5-4, Lady Rattlers. The 2-1. High, 3-1. Three and one the count. One out, bases empty. One run lead. Here's the 3-1. High ball four. So Lockridge on base for the second time, a double and a walk.
Headed to the plate is number 20.
Akiria Howard. An RBI single put the Lady Braves up 4-1, reached on an error. Base for the second time. One out. The pitch. Low ball one. You look at the all-conference team. FAMU had four players on the all-conference team. One and on the count, one out. Here's the 1-0. Here's a shot up the middle. Cut off at short and a throw to second, safe there. Infield single for Howard, and the Lady Braves have something going here. In the fifth inning, two on and one out.
Runners on first and second.
Now to bring up the freshman, Alana Felton.
Alana Felton.
So Felton at the plate. Let's see how Eugenia Fernandez wants to play this, a sacrificer. Turn her loose. Felton been on base twice. She made contact. Peppers gets the sign. Felton, swing and a miss. For FAMU, Janiyah Davis, Michaela Irvis on the first team. Nia Morgan and Janae Mobley on the second team. This pitch is low. And there were no Lady Braves selected in the all-conference team. Count is one and one, one out. 5-4. KMU's pitch swing and a miss. The count is 1-2. 1-2 the count, one out. One-two pitch. Riser is high. Count is even, 2-2. Two and two the count. One out. Two-two pitch. Popped up on the infield to third. It was infield fly. So now runners on at first and second, two out. And they'll bring up Micah Hall.
At the plate is number seven, Micah Hall.
Four straight freshmen batting for the Lady Braves near the bottom of the lineup. Howard, Felton, Hall, and Cotton, all freshmen in big moments here in the tournament. Pitch is low, ball one. 1-0 the count. Two out. 5-4, Lady Rattlers. Here's the 1-0. A check swing, foul. Count is 1-1, two out. 5-4, FAMU here in the top of the fifth inning. Lady Braves have stranded five. They stranded two in the second, two in the third, one in the fourth. They're up in the fifth. Pitch up and in. Count is 2-1. Two and one the count, two out. Lady Braves, Lady Rattlers, the winner of this game plays tomorrow at noon. The loser is eliminated. Here's the 2-1. Inside, 3-1. Again, you have a pitcher in Lauren Peppers who started yesterday's game, coming in relief here the next day. How much does she have? This is her third inning of work. Here's the 3-1. Ground ball foul. Full count. And Coach Eugenia Fernandez with a decent effort to get that foul ball. Count is full, 3-2.
3-2.
Full count, 3-2. Both runners will be taking off here after this 3-2 pitch. Here's the 3-2. Another foul. Count remains 3-2. Top of the fifth inning. Three and two the count. Two out. Here in the fifth. Here's the pitch. Foul straight back. Solid at bat from Hall. Battling this pitcher, Peppers. Count remains 3-2. Two out, two on. Top of the fifth inning. 5-4, FAMU. Here's the 3-2. A little shot to third. Is it caught? Yes. A little flare caught at third by Gaynor. The side is retired. A walk, a single, two stranded. The Lady Braves have stranded seven runners. Four and a half complete, 5-4 Lady Rattlers. We'll take this timeout. We'll be right back with the bottom of the fifth inning.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future, all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition and bringing it with everything you do in the classroom and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those adding to it.
Welcome back to Gulfport. Glad you can join us here. Game number three. 5-4 FAMU, bottom of the fifth inning. Alexa Villamoy, the number one starter pitching in game two, still in the game for the Lady Braves. As FAMU will send 4, 5, and 6 to the plate, Mobley, Morgan, and Fox. Pitch from Villamoy, fly ball into right center field. It's got to be caught in right, one away by Hall. One down. It'll bring up the catcher, Nia Morgan. One for two, doubled. Wide to first.
18, Nia Morgan.
Morgan at the plate. 5-4. Good ball game here. Back and forth. It was 1-0. Lady Braves led 4-1. FAMU tied it and have a one-run lead. Pitches high. 1-0 the count. Of course, FAMU baseball. One of the top teams in the East. We'll be seeing them in the next couple of weeks in Atlanta. This is hooked foul. All the way on the opposite field. Several fields at our disposal here in case we get backed up. Spread the games out and get caught up. We haven't had to use that. Hope that's the case. 1-1 the count. One out here in the bottom of the fifth inning. 5-4. FAMU over the Lady Braves in an elimination game. This pitch is low. 2-1. The 9 runs scored between these two teams is the highest of the tournament. Previous was 6. 2-1 the count. 1 out. Bases empty. Bottom 5. Here's a ground ball foul. Hour and a half game to this point. Count is 2-2. Two and two, the count, 1 out. Here's the 2-2. Riser is high. Full count. Full count, 3-2 with the bases empty. It's the 3-2 pitch. This is popped up, foul and out of play. Count remains 3-2. Full count, 1 out. 1 run lead, 5-4, BAMU. Here's the 3-2 from Viamoy. Ball 4.
One
out, walk to Morgan.
With 1 out, headed to the plate is number 20.
Second walk issued by Alexa Viamoy. Viamoy has given up 5 runs on 7 hits. She's walked 2. And she has struck out 1. We have a pinch runner here.
Pinch runner for the Raptor is number 9.
Lyria Lee, pinch runner. Lee pinch running.
All right, here we go.
As the plate is number 20, Mia Armstrong.
At the plate is Viaja Armstrong for Fox. A bunt back to Viamoy, and the throw is there. Well, the sack is good. Moves the runner to second.
Brandon with 2 out, a runner on second.
And it'll bring up for FAMU Amaya Gaynor.
And Amaya Gaynor at the plate.
0 for 2 with an RBI. Grounded to third and to second. Big moment in this game. 1-run Lady Braves deficit. I'm sure if you're Eugenia Fernandez, you want to keep this right where it is. Bottom 5, runner at second. It's pitch strike called. Oh, and 1 the count. 2 out. Time called. Two out. Go 0-1 the count, 2 out. Big part in this game, we talk about momentum right now, is with the Lady Rattlers. They came back from a 4-1 deficit. They have a runner at second. And this is hooked foul. Count is 0-2. To the count, 2 out. Five, four, Lady Braves trail through the Lady Rattlers in the elimination game. There's a chopper right back to Viamoy, and the side is retired. So the Lady Rattlers get a walk and a sacrifice, and 1 stranded. The Rattlers have left 5. No top errors. Of the sixth inning coming up, 9-1-2. Five, top 6 coming up for the Lady Braves. We'll get to it after this timeout.
resume run. Hydration drop. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
You join the HBCU family. You become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We go to the top of the sixth inning. Glad you can join us. Looks like a pinch hitter here for the Lady Braves in the nine spot. Kiri Parker, who pitched a gem last night, will pinch hit for Cotton and top of the lineup for the Lady Braves. So Parker, then Edwards and Terry, heart of the lineup coming up for the Lady Braves here. 5-4, FAMU, top of the sixth inning. FAMU's left 5, the Lady Braves have left 7. No chances for both sides. Pitch to Parker for Peppers, low ball 1. This is the fourth inning of work for Peppers. Again, she started last night. Question is, how much does she have? Here's the 1-0. Strike called. Jackson State used the pitcher 2 days in a row in Cuppenbender. Now FAMU using Peppers 2 days in a row. 1-1 the count. Pitch strike called, 1-2. 1-2 the count. 5-4 Lady Braves, an elimination game. Trail, FAMU. Here's the 1-2. Another shot, base hit. Good piece of hitting there by Parker. Was in the hole. Just a little flare into left. Shortstop Hill just couldn't get there. Leadoff single. Tying run at first. Top of the lineup and Christian Edwards. We'll see how Eugenia Fernandez, first-year Lady Braves softball coach, how she plays this. Tying run at first. Want to move them along. A sacrifice. Edwards has been on base a couple of times. She's 2-for-3. She bunts, and it's foul. So, an obvious sacrifice situation. 0-1 the count. Hey, you gotta make something happen right here, baby. 5-4, FAMU. Run on first, nobody out. The 0-1. She lays down a bunt. Pitcher field, and the throw is too late. A bunt single for Edwards, and now 2-on for the Lady Braves. First and second, and Camise Patterson comes out. We might get a change here. So Camise Patterson is gonna come out. Peppers started yesterday. He's pitched 4-plus innings here today. 2-on. Will she stay with Peppers, or will she make a change? This is where your bullpen gets challenged. This is where, how many arms do you have to be able to throw at it? That's the question. Patterson is going to stick with it. He's going to stick with Peppers. So two on, none out. So Kennedy Terry at the plate, she's one for three. Again, you assume a sacrifice situation with first and second, trying to make it second and third. She's squaring the bunt, pitch misses outside. 1-0 the count. 1-0 the count here in the sixth inning. Lady Braves with an opportunity to tie or perhaps go ahead. They wanted to check to see if she bunted at it. She did not. 1-0 the count. Top of the sixth inning. Peppers to Kennedy. Lays it down. Good bunt. And she's safe there. Everybody's safe. So the bases are loaded with nobody out. Two bunt singles. Bases loaded, nobody out. A heck of a chance for the Lady Braves here in the sixth inning. With Janice Wells coming to the plate. Two bunt singles in this inning. They're loaded with nobody out. Wells walk, fly to center, and grounded to the pitcher. Pitch strike called. Best opportunity of the day for the Lady Braves. Bases loaded, nobody out. Down 5-4, top of the sixth inning. Here's the 0-1. Popped up on the infield. She's out, infield fly rule. One out. Bases loaded, one out. Lady Braves have stranded seven runners. They've stranded runners in every inning except the first. Now you got Marche Hunt clean up in a big spot. Bases loaded, one out. Hunt, 2-for-3. Pitch from Peppers. Strike call on the inside corner. Two bunt singles. Bases loaded, nobody out. Wells just fly to short. Bases loaded, one out. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss. Pitch up and in. 0-2. Five-four, FAMU, an elimination game, the second. Texas Southern eliminated Jackson State in game one. Here is the 0-2. Hunt hits this one foul. Off to the left. Right fielder scaled the fence down the left side. I mean, if she caught that, let's say she scaled the fence and caught it, the run would have scored. Count is 0-2. Oh and two the count. The pitch. Riser is high. 1-2. One and two the count. One out. Peppers facing Marche Hunt. Cleanup for the Lady Braves. Alcorn down one. Here's the 1-2. There's a shot. Base hit left field. We have a tie game. And Marche Hunt has tied it up. RBI single. Has tied it up at five. 5-5. Kelsey Lockridge walk and double. Her RBI double made it 3-1. Can she now give the Lady Braves the lead? 5-5 here in the sixth. Pitch to Lockridge. Strike called. 0-1 the count. Oh, it's been a seesaw game. 1-0 FAMU. 4-1 Lady Braves. 5-4 FAMU. Now 5-5 in the sixth. Here's the 0-1. Foul off to the left. Well, you got to give Marche Hunt credit. She doesn't get cheated too much at the plate. Fouled off some tough pitches and got one she wanted to hit, and she did. Count is 0-2. Bases loaded. One out. Here's the 0-2. A pop up to third. Two out. Two away. Bases loaded for the DP, Makiria Howard. Well, Lady Braves got a run to tie it. They had the bases loaded one out. Now bases loaded two out. Pitch to Howard. Swing and a miss. Bases loaded, nobody out. Hunt with a base hit to tie it. And Braves want to add to it. AMU wants to keep it right where it is. 5-5 in the sixth. Bases loaded, two out. The 0-1. 0-2. Two out, bases loaded. A shot down the right side is going to drop there. Two runs are going to score. Three runs are going to score. And the Lady Braves have the lead. 8-5. On a bases clearing double by Howard.
Hey, 2-5, I need you to be tough.
And it's 8-5, Lady Braves with the lead, 4 in the sixth inning.
Braves with 2 out, 3 runs scored, runner on second.
8-5, Lady Braves with the lead. Timely hitting.
21.
Hunt with a base hit, and then a bases clearing double by Howard. Now to bring up Felton, so the seesaw game continues. Lady Braves had a 4-1 lead, lost it. Now they have an 8-5 lead in the sixth. Felton singled, walk, fly to third. So the Lady Braves, 4 runs, 4 hits in the sixth inning. 8-5, 2 out, runner at second. This is popped up to third. Side is retired, but the Lady Braves with a big inning. 7 to the plate. 4 runs, 5 hits. The number 9 hitter led it off. And the Lady Braves now up 8-5. Bottom of the 6th inning. 8-9-1 coming up for FAMU. We'll get to it here from Gulfport after this timeout.
We are a limitless future. Opening new doors. New ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. All in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
When
you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
Bottom of the sixth, Lexa Viamoy, the number one starter. Her team has the lead. I think Eugenia Fernandez might be thinking about some changes here. So the Lady Braves do make a change. Amaya Stevens for Hunt at first. The Lady Rattlers will have 8-9-1 coming up. Blasting game Watson and then top of the lineup. Who knows what these last inning will bring. Lady Braves trying to eliminate FAMU. Lady Braves lost 1-0 to Bama State. FAMU lost to Grambling, 8-5 here in this sixth inning. Lady Braves have the number one, their number one, still in with a 3-run lead in the sixth inning. Blasting game, 1-2. Pitch is high. The Lady Braves batting around. We'll see if Viamoy can regain her touch. Here's the 1-0. Strike call, 1-1. Winner of this game will play tomorrow at noon. Here's a bunt, fielded by Viamoy, and the throw is close and out. Trying to bunt their way on is Blasting Game. How to field your position. And that's exactly what Viamoy did. Gianna Watson, 1-2 with a stolen base.
In number six, Gianna Watson.
Winner of this game plays tomorrow at noon. Pitch to Watson, strike called. Against the loser of Grambling and Bama State. That's the late game. One the count. Alcorn 8, FAMU 5, an elimination game. This pitch strike called. 0-2. 0-2 the count, one out. Bottom of the sixth inning. One out, base is empty. Pitch from Viamoy. Poked it to short. The throw is too late. An infield single for Watson. She's on base twice. She's 2-3.
That'll
bring up Aya Davis. She's 1-3.
Back to the top of the batting order. At the plate is number 14, Tanaya Davis.
Here's a bunt. It's a foul ball. Foul ball. Oh, one the count. Oh, on the count here. One out. There's a butt attempt and an off-speed strike called. Two, one out. The pitch, trying to poke it down the left field line, and it is foul. One out. Here's a shot. And it's going to be a double play, just stepping on the bag, and a double play, and the side is retired. Hit right to Stevens. She tried to chase down Watson. All she had to do was step on the bag. A three unassisted double play, and the side is retired. And we go to the seventh inning, the Lady Braves. With an 8-5 lead, that's a heck of a play. Stevens in for Hunt defensively, and she made a heck of a play. A three unassisted double play, side is retired. Top of the seventh coming up, Lady Braves, the three-run lead. Back after this, timeout.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Resume run. Hydration drop. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
Top of the seventh inning. Lady Braves trying to eliminate FAMU. Another inning to go. Micah Hall will lead it off. She's 0 for 3. Grounded to second. Fly to center. Fly to third. Here's the first pitch low, ball one. Well, FAMU has only used two pitchers. Peppers pitched yesterday. Zenteno started today. And then Peppers came in for her. 1-0 the count in the seventh inning. All 0 for 3 in the eighth spot. 8-5, the Lady Braves. It's been a wild game. FAMU jumped out 1-0. Lady Braves with four runs to lead 4-1. FAMU tied it and grabbed the lead 5-4. But then the Lady Braves with a four-run sixth inning. Here we are in the seventh. Here's the 2-0. Strike called, 2-1. Two and one the count. One of this game plays tomorrow at noon. Here's a shot, base hit, left field. Hall, leadoff single in the left field.
Hall with the
Lady Braves.
Runners on first for Alcorn State.
At the plate is 22,
Jemiah. The Lady Braves have had the leadoff man on in the first inning, in the second inning, the third inning, and in the sixth. So for the seven innings, the leadoff is on. Here's a bunt attempt to throw to first is there. Runner trying to get to third, and the throw is too late. There is nobody covering third, and good hustle by Hall going from first to third. So the sack is good, and Hall didn't stop running. The play was right in front of her. Gaynor came up, and Hall obviously saw that there was no one covering third, and she took it. So Christian Edwards, top of the lineup, trying to give the Lady Braves a little insurance here. 8-5 here in the top of the seventh inning. There's a ground ball to third. Looks the runner back to third, and the throw crosses there. Two away.
Now with two out, runner on third at the plate.
And it'll bring up Kennedy Terry.
Here's number four.
Kennedy Terry trying to give the Lady Braves a four-run lead. The pitch to Terry, strike call.
Number 13, Kennedy Terry.
Count is 0-1. 8-5, Lady Braves in the seventh inning. Here's the 0-1. It's a ground ball, base hit. Timely hitting, Kennedy Terry. With a single, three straight singles for Terry, and it's 9-5. Denise Wells. Wells 0-3 with a walk. 9-5, Lady Braves. Lady Braves with a run on two hits in this seventh inning. Fouls it off to the left side. Winner of this game plays tomorrow at noon. Count is 0-1. Losers eliminated. Here's the 0-1. Miser's high. 1-1. Lauren Peppers in relief of Zenteno, who went 2 2/3 innings. This is the fifth inning of work for Peppers. Started last night's game into five innings of work here. A foul off to the left side. Count is 1-2. Winner of this game plays at noon against the loser of Grambling and Bama State. You win this game, you get a chance to get off your feet, enjoy the rest of the day. 1-2 the count, two out, runner at first, a run is in for the Lady Braves. Here's the pitch. Misses, runner going, and the throw, and it is too late. Stolen base for Terry. Count is even, 2-2. 2-2 the count. Two out. Here's the 2-2. One hop to the catcher, full count. 14 runs in this game has elapsed what we had for four games yesterday. Matched it. Count is full, 3-2. Two out. Here's the 3-2. This is hook foul. Count remains 3-2. Two out. Seventh inning. Lady Braves with a 9-5 lead. Trying to eliminate the Lady Rattlers. Full count 3-2. Two out. Popped up. Fouling out of play.
Hey, but win it, G, win it.
Count is full, 3-2. Three and two, two out. The pitch. A little flare, it's gonna drop in for a base hit. The runner's held up at third, it gets away, and a single and an error. And the inning continues for the Lady Braves as Wells is at second.
Braves, two out, a runner on second and third.
Time called. Again, we might have a pitching change here. We might. Looking into the dugout and into the bullpen. Trying to get this third out. Again, this is the fifth inning of work for Peppers. She started yesterday. So you just have to wonder, again, how much does Peppers have? And they're going to stick with her. You just wonder how many arms she has left to be able to go to at this point.
Let's go, big baby.
I mean, there was a couple of times in which I thought that she might be pulled. Again,
once again,
it's asking a lot.
And
Peppers has hung in.
Amaya Stevens.
So Amaya Stevens at the plate. Trying to add to the 9-5 lead. Stevens. With the runners at second and third in front of her. Pitch to Stevens. Swing and a miss. Oh, and won the count. Lady Braves have batted around. A 9-5 lead. It's the 0-1. Strike called, 0-2 on the inside corner. Oh, and 2 the count, two out. Oh, 2 pitch. Swing and a miss. Side is retired. Lady Braves, a run on a couple of hits. They add to their lead. It's 9-5. Bottom of the seventh coming up. Lady Braves get these three outs. They eliminate FAMU, and they'll take on the winner of Grambling Bama State tomorrow at noon. Three outs to get, bottom of the seventh. Coming up after this, timeout.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Dropping. Rapid rehydration initiated. Unlock specialized blend of 5 electrolytes.
Rapid rehydration to get you back on your game. Gatorlyte, now available in powder and Gatorlyte Zero Sugar.
Second elimination game as we approach the halfway point of day number two. This game in terms of runs has tied the total amount of runs we had in four games yesterday. Lexa Villamoy, the number one starter for the Lady Braves, has gone all the way. Zenteno went 2 2/3 innings for the Lady Rattlers. Peppers took over from there.
Heading into
the bottom of the seventh inning.
Bottom of the seventh inning, down 9-5. At the plate for the Rattlers is number four, Michaela Irvis.
Two hits, walked once, 2-3. Pitch, strike called. Well, Villamoy has the runs. She makes the pitches in the defense work. 0-1 the count. It's Villamoy inside, 1-1. Again, if the Lady Braves win this game, they eliminate FAMU. They'll play the winner of tonight's game, or the loser of tonight's game, I should say, Bama State and Grambling. Both teams won yesterday. Of course, Bama State beat the Lady Braves. Grambling won 3-1. Here's the pitch inside. Good pitch inside. Count is 2-1. 2-1 the count here in the seventh inning. 9-5 Lady Braves. Here's the 2-1. Ground ball to second on two hops. One out.
One out for the Rattler.
One away.
Headed to the plate is number 12, Breanne Hill.
Breanne Hill. A fielder's choice, reached on an air and fly to center. Coming up next are winners games, Bethune-Cookman and Prairie View, and later Grambling and Bama State. 9-5, which is high, ball one. One and all the count, one out. This pitch is a strike call on the inside corner, 1-1. 9-5, Lady Braves. Lady Braves got their runs in bunches. They were down 4-1. They're up 4-1 and trailing 1-0, and then got, and they trail 5-4. So three big innings. There's a little ground ball to second. The throw is there, two away. Lady Braves, one big out to get. And Mobley stands in. Glide to short. Glide to right twice. She's 0-3. Lady Braves win this game. They'll play tomorrow at noon and eliminate FAMU. Pitch from Villamoy. Popped up to center field, and this will do it. The Lady Braves eliminate FAMU 9-5. So the Lady Braves eliminate the Lady Rattlers, and they will take on the loser of Grambling Bama State right back here tomorrow at noon. That'll do it here from Gulfport, game number two. Final score, 9-5. Lady Braves eliminate FAMU. I'm Charles Edmond. Glad you can join us. We'll talk to you soon. So long.
When you join the HBCU family, you become part of the tradition of breaking barriers in your community, breaking ground in your career, and bringing it with everything you do. From how you look to how you move in the classroom, on the court, and on the field. That's why Academy Sports and Outdoors is proud to celebrate the HBCU legacy and all those to add to it in their own way.
We are a limitless future, opening new doors, new ways, new everything. We are past, present, and future. all in one. Because the best way to honor our history is to make history. Chevrolet, honored to support the Southwestern Athletic Conference.